P.T. Barnum presents The Divine Jenny Lind. The mid-19th century in America was a time of great excitement, change, growth, and trepidation. Broader exposure to the modes and manner of European cultural tastes was intriguing and offered variety. The pursuit of refinement and cultural enlightenment assisted in molding a new American society that was eager to advance its standard of civility. Leisure time was filled with activities that promoted self-betterment. Familiarity with the arts, music, and literature became a building block in constructing a virtuous, intellectual, and enlightened character. Barnum was typical of this attitude. Although professionally he catered to the amusement desires of the masses, he found greater enjoyment in classical entertainment, stating, "I myself relish a higher grade of amusement, and I was a frequent attendant at the opera, first-class concerts, lectures, and the like." During the mid-1840s, Jenny Lind, known throughout the continent as the Swedish Nightingale, was the toast of England and Europe. The perfection of her voice captivated audiences, commanding performances at the courts of England, Scandinavia, and Germany. While abroad on the successful European engagement of Tom Thumb, P.T. Barnum contemplated an American tour by the famous Swedish coloratura soprano. After months of negotiation, the terms of the amazing venture were fixed, and the agreement was drawn. It was concluded that Lind was to receive $1,000 a night for her performances, up to $150,000 for compensation during the tour. That's close to $5 million today. In addition, all expenses, including servants, a secretary, three musical assistants, and related transportation and board, would be assumed by Barnum. The terms of the contract served both parties. Lind received an enormous monetary guarantee from the tour, affording her the opportunity to realize her dream of establishing a musical academy for girls in Stockholm. And in return, she was ordained Barnum's instrument of reformation, furthering his ideals of making theater-going moral, benevolent, educational, and entertaining. The first concert was scheduled to take place at Castle Garden in New York City on September 11, 1850, and the house quickly sold out. A continuous stream of carriages arrived hours beforehand. More than 5,000 people filled the garden, and thousands more crowded outside, hoping to catch faint echoes of the concert. The moment of incantation arrived, and a public filled with anticipation, including an anxious Barnum, waited with hearts pounding to hear Jenny Lind's first angelic notes. Barnum confesses in his autobiography that his anticipation and that of the public might be too high to be realized, and hence that there would be a reaction after the first concert. "But I was happily disappointed. The transcendent musical genius of the Swedish Nightingale was superior to all that fancy could paint, and the Führer did not attain its highest point until she had been heard." People were in ecstasies. The moment did not fade. The New York concerts differed very little in musical presentation, yet each program was filled to capacity. By the end of the New York engagement, the Lind concerts generated $87,055.89. That's $3 million today. Barnum received hundreds of letters each day from establishments in cities all over the United States, hoping to confirm a Lind concert booking. Working tirelessly, he devised the American tour schedule, confirming concerts for Providence, Rhode Island, Boston, Massachusetts, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and Washington, D.C. for President Millard Fillmore, and reaching as far south as New Orleans, Louisiana, and Havana, Cuba. The tour continued up the Mississippi River, appearing in Natchez, Mississippi, Memphis, Tennessee, St. Louis, Missouri, Nashville, Tennessee, and Madison, Indiana. Lind then performed in Cincinnati, Ohio, Wheeling, West Virginia, and Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, before returning to New York for another 14 concerts. The entourage was greeted in almost every city with accolades equal to those in New York. On June 3, 1851, the New York Daily Tribune reported that after 9 months of constant publicity and tour management details, Barnum and Lind decided to terminate the enterprise. All financial terms and stipulations of contractual forfeit for closing the engagement more than 50 concerts early were deemed amicable by Jenny Lind. The total receipts of the American concerts amounted to $712,161.43. That's nearly $24.5 million today. Barnum's aspiration of reconstructing social attitude toward the theater was realized as the American entertainment industry flourished and gained momentum. Subsequently, Barnum's pursuit of respectability and social gratitude was found in the Lind Endeavor, enabling him to identify and justify his cultural and intellectual sophistication within the mid-19th century genre. As Barnum's instrument, Lind captured the nation's passion and spirit. The message of her music and integrity of her character resonated to audiences throughout America. Art and its methodical force have been preserved through time. Jenny Lind as the legendary symbol of artistic purity and benevolence, and P.T. Barnum as the great American showman. Although Barnum was considered extreme in his methods, a concept at times still shared today, he must be acknowledged and credited with significant contributions to the face of American entertainment and the art of making entertainment great.